of those tournaments that he could have gotten third or better. Third, maybe second if you beat Kasev.
Yep, it's the volatileness of our upper mid-level players.
Upper mid-level players are disgusting. Everybody, I hate them. I hate all of us.
Anybody that is, what's crazy is that anybody that's on the spreadsheet in the PR watch list,
yeah,
those are players that can get anywhere from
13th to third.
13th to third.
Yeah,
13th. They're players that can take names from they can take the names off of the top level players.
Yeah.
And they can just do almost they can be on fire one day and
yeah, bust drop the next day. Honestly.
Alright, so we got
Mikey PZO. Now I think Mikey might have a bit of an issue with this matchup because wow, okay.
I was about to say, I'm like, I know something's just telling me
you know
that
what?
I don't think Mike
is
going to.
I didn't say anything. I'm just not going to speak anymore. It's cool.
Because I don't know if you knew this. The last time Mikey was playing Zenodo earlier today.
Uh-huh.
And Mikey said that he nearly did beat Zenodo in game 3.
Wow, okay.
And by the time game 3 was happening, he was already understanding all of Zenodo's habits.
Oh, really?
And what makes me think that just speaks to Mikey as a player, and I believe it just shows Mikey is very comfortable with the Diddy matchup, because you might not know this, but back in Brawl, Mikey was one of the only people who had a positive record on Zenodo.
Oh, no, I did not know that.
By the time Brawl ended, Mikey was the only one outside of, like, Ally that had a positive record on Zenodo.
That's fascinating. Man, this man is so good at this character. Like, literally, I go home and watch this man play Peach. That's literally what I do when I get to my bedroom. Like, I go on YouTube and I immediately look at the sets that Gucci uploaded.
Shout out to Gucci. Especially if they're being processed immediately when they end.
Right?
Shout anyway, out.
Hey, Gucci.
Product placement.
Yeah. But yeah, no, this match.
The footstool?
I think he had gone down there and buried. That might have been it, but.
Should have just gone down there and just fastballed down air.
Yeah.
Because those hits are so light enough, it really wouldn't have sent Diddy anywhere.
And that's going to be the stock. PZO making a real comeback after that 0-to-death. Ah. Okay. Forward throw, interesting. Doesn't want to do the down throw. I think he's just trying to get him off stage.
Yeah, he is. Because I think at this point, the best thing that...
Wow.
The thing that PZO is going to be looking for is going to be one of those YOLO dares. Because YOLO dare, while Peach is recovering, is probably going to be one of those things that actually saves him the game and actually... turns it around.
It's a little hard though. Before, a couple days ago, I would have said that it's actually impossible because Peach's uppie is very disjointed, so it just beat out dare normally. But that, it's happened to me before at friendlies. That stuff is traded. Like, I've seen, whoa, okay. I've seen Peach try to uppie and Diddy dare and have them trade and have Peach die. It occurs, it happens. But yep. Now it's coming at that percent where down tilt to up smash might with rage or F smash. Wow, PZO with the pop off.
PZO with
clutching.
The banana to Swanky Express.
Yo.
The one-way ticket is the banana.
Yeah. That was so clutch. I am shocked that he won that game.
Yeah.
He looked, I mean, that looked like it was Mikey's game to lose. After
it was.
That combo at the beginning.
It was.
Some stuff. Yeah. What I was going to say was that PZO was going to probably anti-air him with forward air, like you were saying earlier. Probably the best anti-air in the game, legitimately. Like, hugely disjointed hitbox that is Diddy's fair. But
the counterpick to Battlefield.
I'm not sure how I feel about this.
I think I like it a little bit better.
It's better than Smashville, for sure.
Yeah.
But I think, I don't know, FD was also a legitimate choice.
But you don't know, maybe PZO banned it. Most people should know that Peach is very, benefits a lot from stages like FD and Duck Hunt.
Yeah.
And for me personally, those are my instant 2 bans.
Right. I mean, you ban Duck Hunt against Peach. That character is... it's busted on Duck Hunt. So
imagine
silly.
Like it's like Ice Climbers and Brawl level, like so good for this character.
Yeah, it's so silly. Oh man. Oh my god, these conversions. Okay, fair, get off me.
Man, Mikey.
Poor shield.
What's crazy is that the way Mikey's playing, it looks like he still has a lead. And he does not. He's down about 50% here. But he's still fighting like it's even.
Yeah, he's fighting like he's the aggressor in this situation. I don't know. Mikey doesn't really run.
No, Mikey's always in your face, ruthless aggression play style,
yep.
Saying, "Hey, you can't breathe. I'm still in front of you."
Right. Exactly. Or over you, usually.
Yeah. tap, tap, tap.
Just regain stage control immediately with those with that double dare. Oh no, not quite spacing that right. Dash attack. Oh wow.
So safe. The changes that they did in Smash 4 2. Peach's dash attack is unreal.
Yeah, it's so weird now. God, that just shield pressure. He tried to shield guy, but he couldn't even do it because he was so far away. Fair safe on shield now. Well, not safe, but safe from a shield grab. Oh, man. Back throw? Not going to take it.
Yeah. Mikey looking for a way to get back on stage. And he says, hey, you're coming out here to throw a banana at me? Here's a crown. And now I've got stage control.
Pizio's expression when he got hit by that fair gives me life. I was going to say, oh, my God, he almost got hit by that turn up. That was so close. I thought that was a stock. I thought he was dead. Up smash. Raw up smash. No hit confirm, no read, just okay.
And Mikey says, or not.
Yeah, PZO shaking
his
head.
He's like, oh, you took that stock? Actually, well, now we're even.
Yep. Yeah, PZO really coming out in this tournament, though.
Yeah, Mikey is definitely one of these players that say, hey, I'm not looking for that 20 in a handshake. Because right here, this is loser semifinals, and we are fighting to see who will be fighting the loser of K7 and Zenodo.
Yes. Definitely the two titans of this tournament right now.
Exactly. Well, just two of the strongest titans, two of the Michigan's strongest players, and
literally
the strongest players in the Midwest in general.
Oh, wow. That Tech Chase with them. Floating up there. I love this character, and I love watching Mikey play. I thought that was a fair confirm, but no, I think he's a little too high percent now.
Whoa!
Oh my God!
Whoa! Oh my God! That read was incredible.
74%.
Wow! That F smash. He knew. He had to have known the side B was coming.
Or he's just like, let's throw it out.
Yeah, I'm.
Because Mikey is one of those unconventional players.
You're gonna hit. You're gonna get hit by this though.
Mikey is one of the most unconventional players you'll ever meet with how he plays his characters.
Man.
So seeing that F smash, it's surprising. Just because you're like, wow.
I don't know.
I didn't even think that could even be an option.
Yeah, I like. It's one of those things you get hit by, and you're like, I don't know if I'm bad at this game or not. Am I bad at this game? Like, you have to think in your head.
It's one of those things where you're like, okay.
Okay. Like,
I guess.
I guess. Sure.
game three.
Town and City.
We got Town and City. We got Bubblegum KK.
I would not have picked this against Peach. Down tilt to Uppy is so real on the stage. I mean, Mikey doesn't use down tilt as much as some other Peaches do, but it'll kill you at like 110.
Wait, Peach can do down tilt Uppy?
Down tilt Uppy is a combo.
That
it's like a real thing.
That is disgusting.
Yeah.
Coats, don't start doing that.
It's so mad. You feel so bad about losing to it, because then you get to see Peach like float. Like,
just
so
carelessly
like, yeah,
float
careless,
down
like,
in the wind.
LOL, your stock is gone, like basically. And now we have some real camping.
Yep.
Okay.
And you can see PZO, he's actually being a lot more respectful.
Yeah, he's being like, okay, I lost the game. I have to take this seriously because I really don't want to just get.
Mikey did not get that footstool. He would have actually had a lot more dangerous of a combo off of it.
He's gonna side B. Oh, he reads it, but he doesn't get the hiccup from off the turnip, just the turnip itself. Just a little damage. I think based on the velocity, actually, of the turnip, how much damage it does.
Oh, really?
I believe it is. If you did it really close, it's 12 damage. You get it farther away, it's like 7. That's for a normal turnip, that is.
Okay.
Not even considering special turnips.
All right. Mikey does have to be careful. He is in down tilt up smash percent
right
range.
Oh, but wow. Okay,
good
great
DI.
I was
able to say, all right, and
he's
going hit by
so
that
far
up smash.
So far to the right, it was a little silly. All right, Mikey's off stage. Oh,
all
I was expecting an up-eat. I think that the up air, he was trying to get the second hit so he could come back, but he didn't get it. If he had up-eat, I think it would have popped him upwards and made it safe. But that was a little bit more risky of an option, because had he missed that, he would have definitely taken an up smash, F smash.
You're 100% right there.
Yeah, oh wow, he went right past the stage. Still got the ledge though. So PZO gonna try his hardest to extend this lead. He's probably gonna get a random smash attack. I was gonna say,
and it was
up
a tennis
smash,
racket.
F smash, like it. Just, something's gonna hit you and it's gonna kill you.
Yep. So the next time we see Mikey throw an F smash, it's likely gonna be the frying pan, because I believe the order goes golf, tennis, cooking.
I think it's actually tennis, golf, frying pan, tennis. So I believe it is.
I don't know. I don't play Peach enough to.
Yeah,
see.
I play.
I don't see Peaches use F smash quite like Mikey enough to know where I can count. I can actually see what the actual order is.
It's kind of like Olimar. Like I definitely know the order in my head, but if I'm trying to play a game, I'm not paying attention.
It was a really good dash attack there. It actually, Diddy Kong was trying to punish it the moment it was whiffed.
Uh-huh.
But the moment he unshielded, he got hit by part two.
Yeah.
And it made him forfeit stage control.
Yeah,
completely.
definitely two hit move. Good up smash. Incredible anti-air. I don't think Mikey got the nair.
Forward smash.
Is that
gonna end it?
Oh
Mikey
no.
Living
Wow, we lived those, I guess.
By the thread of his dress.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
right
neutral.
On it. PZO popping off like, whoa. Popping off super hard.
All right, guys. So PZO takes that after
a hard-fought
three games.